I am going to be giving the upper hand to ESC. ESC is looking pretty darn strong at the moment. They have they've not really faltered at all so far from what I've seen on the last two rounds. So I think that they have they're going to have what it takes to take the win. MHSV, they did come off of a loss in Miami. It was a very close loss, so it's not like they were down and out. It's not like they just got crushed. So I don't know. Maybe ESC is just that much better than MHSV. So we will see. And it does seem like we have a three-man push gearing up out here to that Bravo site. Nobody going into the Alpha push as we had seen yesterday. And Banching is going to be looking out, spots out one. Oh, the rocket play is real. And Banching will get taken down. Drar going straight for that C-cap. And he's going to be able to get the burn on it right now. Did we get the last kill? We did. And that's going to be a very quick CA hold coming out for ESC. Doobie also going to be up next to those tanks as he will be able to spot out one. Not quite able to get any of the shots off on him. Does have to back up. Finally gets taken down. All five players are going to be back up over here next to tanks. As a draw. Hoo, 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 hoo. Nice shot on Mr. Nevix. Smooth goes down, and this is going to be still a two-man push, a three-man push now onto this B site. And this is really, really critical right now, guys. I mean, they're able to bottle this team up into this B, into the B flag. Drar is also going to be coming around with those reses, and that means that B flag will be going over into their possession. Hup is going to be on the backside of Alpha, able to take down one. And he's going to be able to keep this Alpha flag. So we are going to be seeing a three cap in favor of ESC right from the start. And this is definitely not looking good for MHSV. Honestly, at this particular point, man, I don't know. They're just getting completely wiped around the board. TY is going to be coming up from below into tunnels. And he does spot out. He knows there's at least one guy down in here. Benny, not able to stay alive. He does go down. Tries to get the res as well. Won't happen. And the teammates for ESC are going to be able to clean that up quite well. Toffee with the pick on Mr. Nevix. 143 to 107. Seven tickets have been lost here for ESC. Definitely looking darn good. And now TY is going to be able to get the assist on one. The push coming on the C flag is going to be able to happen here. Ooh, Hup. Not staying alive there for too long. Nevix will be able to secure that Alpha point, but they've been in that triple cap for so darn long. I mean, look how far behind they are at the moment. They will be able to secure the C flag. They will be able to secure A. And now TY going to be playing some defense out here. Spots out Benny. Will be able to get the pickup, but there's going to be one right behind him. This is going to be Toffee here, and he is actually he's a little bit low on health now. I'm going to say he could challenge that fairly easily. And TY is actually stuck, and oh, can't get the hit fire spray. Goes down. Banshee, though, going to follow that back up. Using that CZ, not going to be enough. He ends up getting taken out, and look at this. Mr. Smooth said, screw that. He's going straight for that B site. Could actually be a saving grace here if they can stay alive here onto the Alpha flag, and they do stay alive for now. TY going to be able to spot out one up through mid. That's going to be Toffee. 135-86. They do get that two-cap bleed for the moment, but they do have that Alpha Bravo. This is a weird setup to have. This is going to really be interesting as a Banshee. Oh, he has to reload. Still staying alive. Oh, my God. Going to be able to get help from his teammates. Nice job there. And, yes, guys did not know. You can blow out that that wall with the Magnum, and that is going to be a BC hold still here for MHSV. Very nice job done. And Benny going to be trying to follow that back up onto Alpha. Going to Akrage right here. He's going to be able to get the hit fire spray. Nice job using that CZ, which is just a face melter. Saw a couple of players not too happy about the CZ yesterday. I believe it was on, was it on Goldman Railway? I think it was. And now Toffee and Benny are going to be gearing up for a two-man push here. We do see Banshee playing a little bit of defense. Going to be going in for a back rage of his own. Spots out one and two. Easy pickups there for Banshee. Nice play. And definitely recognizing where he needs to be. But the transitions to that Bravo side, not even going to have to happen, really, as Ginyu is going to be over here already. Nevik's going to be shifting over to that Alpha Flag. They're going to be going in for a triple cap of their own. And that 40 to 50 ticket lead that we did see at the very beginning, well, that's pretty much gone. Oh, two players down onto Alpha Flag. He does get back rage here, but they have backed him up. And look at that, getting a Sirocco kill on Vinny. Oh, my God. Oh, Banching, I love you, man. I love you. As also going to be able to get a couple of assists, and that is going to be a firm BC hold once again for MHSV. TY going to be playing defense here up top. There you go, going to be spotting out Benny. Can't connect with the shots. That's actually a huge deal. That's a four-man push gearing up for that C flag. Toffee going to be setting up into mid, already waiting for the push onto A flag. We do have Nevix and Ginnu here to try and make something happen. But 89-77, MHSV actually almost took the lead. They will be able to secure this alpha point, but B is going to be getting contested at the moment. And that's going to be Doobie getting that last and final kill there to do just that. They do have that Bravo Charlie cap for now. Banching, though, getting a couple of good clean kills on this B site. Finally goes down. We got a lot of trades happening going back and forth. And that is going to be a four-man wipe there, as Ginnu will be the last player up and alive. Going to go for a back rage onto the B site. Don't think if that was the wisest decision there in that situation. I probably would have just I don't know what I would have done there, honestly. He probably did what he needed to do at that time, but it was just all around bad spot to be in. As Hup is going to be transitioning over here to this alpha site. He's going to be able to spot out one. Nice pickups there, recognizing that they're probably going to be up in the tunnel. Probably going to be pushing that C flag. This is going to force a couple of players back to Alpha, as Banching will be able to clean it up, but he had to. That actually brought back three players to A. Now, they did secure the C site, so let's see if they can actually hold on to it. They have a two-man push gearing up for B at the moment. It's going to be a one-on-three situation here, and yeah, this is definitely not a position that you want to be in. Ginyu does get taken down, and smart play there from who was that over here? That was a smart play for Nevix. He just backed up. He said, you know what? We already know that there's going to be the majority of the players out there on the B. Don't have to push that. Let's just play defense on A and C. And that's exactly what they're doing. Tight TY will be able to pick up one. Spots out another one. And C and A both going to be getting flashed, as well as B. So all three flags are being contested at the moment. And TY, oh, he's not going to be able to get down in there in time. Spots out one more. Can't get the hit fire spray. And that is going to be a C flag going over into the favor here of ESC. As Mr. Nevix getting onto that B flag will be able to secure that. We're going to be seeing Banching also going over here to Alpha. But can they hold off on this counterattack to B? And it looks like Drar will go down. It's going to come down to a one-on-three situation. Benny here, not going to be able to survive. He gets taken down very, very fast, but they can't leave B completely uncontested. And a very smart move here by Nevix. Does he spot it out? No, he doesn't. Gets shot from behind. And we even saw TY just shifting back over there looking because he did hear the callouts for it. And there you go. Ginyu get taken down as well. So that means that C flag not going to be getting pressured. Or not going to be going into the favor here of MHSV. 54 to 38 tickets, a lot closer than what it was on Siege of Shanghai. But I don't know if MHSV is going to be able to pull it out. They did have that 2-cap for a few moments, but now they got to get on the C flag. Too far away really to do anything onto B, and all five of their players are going to be up into mid. Drar are going to be down below. We do see Vinny trying to play a little bit of defense out here, as Mr. Nevix is going to be pressuring this, and I don't know. Oh, he misses his shot. Benny had a chance, but no, it's not going to be enough. And the two-man push down below was successful. Hup is going to be going down. He will be able to spot out one. Can't connect with any of the shots. And C-Flag will be going over into their possession. But Gerard with the back A spawns. One of the reasons why CA is a fairly difficult hold to have is because of those back A spawns. And once again, we are going to be seeing Alpha getting contested. Spawns are going to be coming off on Gerard. 44 to 28. And Banching was able to actually get a kill there and get the flag back. So nice job there for MHSV. Now, they don't need to get too aggressive on Bravo. If they're going to be getting aggressive on B, they need to pull back to C and let A alone, which is exactly what they're doing. So smart moves there, as Smoove is going to be transitioning, maybe just to harass a little bit. But B and A are both getting contested and switching. TY going to be able to take down Toffee. See if he can have another one. And he does. He's going to be able to take down Benny as well. Nice play. And that will be a failed push on C. Let's see if Doobie is going to be able to make something happen. A little bit trigger happy there. Doesn't know where they're going to be coming from. TY once again with another great defense. He is heating up right now. And that is going to be a triple cap potentially coming in here as Alpha is going to be flashing. 27-27, MHSV going to be able to even it up in the second map, first round, and take the lead for the first time in this match. And now ESC is definitely on the back foot. They will be able to secure the C flag for now. They did get the mid push. Let's see if Ginyu is going to be able to get a couple of kills here. Nope, he does end up going down. We do have Nevix, though, spawning back in here. It's going to be a two-on-two situation. Now a two-on-one with B-Flag. Needs to start returning back into the favor here of MHSV. They don't need to give this B-Flag up, and they're able to get the kill. But now the reinforcements coming in for ESC. Can they hold on to this? Rockets are going to be coming out into play. Nice hit fire sprays. Drar does end up going down. Benny going to be coming in from the backside. Six tickets left to 21. Not too many spawns can come in, and that is going to be it. Nobody is over there onto Alpha. Nobody's going to be able to push on to B, and that is going to be a 21-3. Now one. 21 tickets will be your final score for round number one for MHSV. So for the first time in this match, we have actually seen MHSV coming out on top. Let's see what they're going to be able to do here in the next round. Now this is do or die for them. If they get caught out here, they are done. They won't even have a chance. Well, they might have a chance within the Go 4 series, but they will not have the possibility to go for the last and final group, the group four. So they have to make it happen now. This is do or die time. And ESC, it's the same thing. I mean, it's do or die time, but they have one map they can give up. So the pressure isn't going to be too bad on them. And it says it's a 2-0 for Fnatic. Huh. Reading over here, was the MYM match already over? No way the MYM match is already over. All right, well, anyways, I was trying to get some updates there on the on Skype. Not too sure exactly what's happening, so if you guys do know, just definitely post down into chat, let me know. As I can't watch the other one while I am casting, unfortunately. But we have switched sides. ESC going to be down on the Chinese side. We are going to be seeing, or US side. We are going to be seeing MHSV on the Russian side. Now, does MHSV go for a very heavy C push? What we've seen in the past is a two-man push coming down into C to try and cap that very, very quickly. They pretty much forget about Alpha. They do send one player over to Alpha, but they don't really put too much emphasis on trying to cap it. And here we go. We are going to be seeing Drar as well as Benny going straight up to A. Benny going to be playing in mid. Drar going to be going over for Alpha. And it looks like Smooth going to be able to come on top versus Drar. So nice play there. Banching getting taken down by Benny. That does leave this mid push open. And B-Flag going to be going over into the possession of MHSV, which means that they will. Oh, nice shot there. Taking out Hup. Which means that they are going to be able to secure themselves the two-flag bleed and the lead here for this match. And remember, they won by 21 tickets, so that's a good thing. That's a very, very good thing for them. And I would love to see a Lockers map. That's going to be the third and final map. If it does go to a number three, I'd love to see Lockers. But Hup right now getting onto Alpha Flag. He does get taken down by Nevix, but not before that Alpha Flag was capped back over. And that's going to come down to a one-on-one. Drar versus Nevix. Can he come out on top? Doesn't. That's going to be Nevix once again, as he is just killing all sorts of foos here. And he's going to be able to pick up one more. That's Benny going down. And Nevix is going off on these guys. He's going to be able to spot out one more going up through mid. Teammates, though, should be able to finish that off. That's going to be Mr. Smooth here coming in for a back rage here. Catches one right out of the open. And that's going to be Hup going down. Let's see if he spots out a second one. He does. Can he connect? He trades out with Gerard. With one left standing, that means that C-Flag will be going over here for ESC. But definitely doing a lot of good work in the meantime, getting a couple of kills and delaying any kind of a counterattack on the B or A. We do have TY going out very, very aggressively here. See if he can get a back reach onto that C flag. Looks like it's going to come down to a one-on-one onto B. Now one-on-two. Reinforcements coming in from that Charlie site. But as we say that, C is going to get flashed as Banshee gets taken down. TY going to be coming in for the reinforcements. Can he hold on here? They really, really need to. It's going to be Gerard, and he does. He takes down one, and that is going to be a CA hold now for MHSV. 139 to 111. They do have the lead, and they're not looking too darn bad, I have to say, as we do have Toffee waiting for the reinforcements to come back in the squads. Not going to be able to stay alive there, but Gerard coming in gets a pick of his own, and they stop the mid-push as well. So looking pretty darn good here for MHSV coming right out of the gate, and they will be bottlenecking them onto this B site. It's going to be Hup and Doobie not going in for those random spawns, instead going in for the B spawns. And where are the random spawns? I've not seen anybody go for random spawns. They're all going on squad spawns. TY getting a little bit chased here. Oh my god, two-man push onto TY. Not going to be able to do anything there. But Banching, he's like, you know what, screw it. We're going to go for a three-cap. He's going to be able to get the gray out? No, he doesn't get the gray out just yet. But he is going to be able to really cause a lot of distraction here. Look at this. Pulled back three players from ESC. Nobody was able to attack A. Nobody was able to attack C. And now with a one-on-two situation. Oh, Nevek's going to be coming out on top. Will he be able to stay alive? He does! And that means that nobody is back here onto that B side. That's a three-man wipe for ESC. TY going to be trying to hunt down these last couple of players. He's going to be able to pick up one. No, he doesn't pick up one. Goes down, in fact. Both of them are super, super weak. And Gunu is going to be waiting for any kind of a counterattack coming in. And this did delay that push. Alpha Flag is now going to be getting flashed. 134 to 67. Nice hit fire spray from Gunu. We'll be able to take down Toffee. And the reinforcements did show up for MHSV, so they should be just fine. But Benny, though, having something else to say about it, takes down Gino. Where is Nevix? Nevix and TY are both going to be down here, just going back and forth. Benny does finally go down. And looking at the minimap right now, that's going to be another three-man wipe with Alpha Flag still going to be in the possession here of ESC. But 131 to 53. This is a pretty brutal situation. Remember, 21 tickets is the ticket count that they have to beat. And they only have about 30 left with Banshing getting taken down into mid. We do have a counterattack from TY going straight for that alpha site. Mr. Smooth going to be able to secure B as well. And this was just MHSV all day long. Oh my god, where was this team in round number one? TY going to be able to secure alpha right now. Drar going to be trying to hold this down. Oh, he did get on it. He's not going to be canceling out just yet. And that was going to be TY getting the kill. Nice play there. As Smooth going to be coming up for the attack on C flag. With this contain, I think that they are going to be able to finish out this match here. 38 tickets left to 128. ESC would have to pull out a miracle in order to come out on top. And Doobie is already calling for next map. And they know they've lost it. I mean, Benny's going to be able to get onto A, but C flag is going to be transitioning now. And that is going to be it. 34 tickets left, 126. And Doobie is like, next map, go next map. They've already given up, thrown out the GG. So congratulations there to MHSV. They did a superb job, really just dismantling ESC. I mean, they slapped them around silly. We are going to see 15-5 for Ginnu, 10-1 for Nevix. Wow, Nevix, though, holding it down. I mean, he was definitely beasting up there on the Charlie flag, so congrats there. And, so Fnatic did win 2-0 over MYM. That is impressive this fast. I wonder how brutal the scores were actually at. If you guys know the scores, post them in chat. I would love to know. Because we could see a MHSV MYM rematch, which would be awesome. I would love to see that. So here we are in lockers currently. And this is going to be a pretty interesting match. We do have ESC dropped one, so we're not going to be going live on this particular match. But, yeah, so Lockers. Let's talk a little bit Lockers. Lockers is a good map. I love Lockers. I love me some Lockers. If you don't know it, I like Lockers. I like Lockers because it's not a very oblong-shaped map. You can pretty much get to every one of the flags fairly easily and within the same amount of time. You can get to A and B a lot faster, obviously. But it's not like Zavod where you have one hold that just can't make it. I mean, you can pretty much win Lockers with every hold in the game. Oh my god, TY. Oh, that's funny. If you guys don't know, I won't explain. But you can pretty much hold with BC, you can hold it with CA, you can hold it with AB. You can hold this map any way you want. Now, the harder hold will be the BC hold. That's the most difficult one, because you do have to watch out for the back B spawns. Now, what has kind of come into popularity here, and something that is very brutal, if you can control the back B spawns, is A and B, with pushing them outside of C. And what you do is you have a guy that sits over here, either by Gypsy, or he kind of sits back over here by the crates on the left side of Alpha here, and he just holds them outside the tunnel. Then you have another guy that sits over here in the snake, and one down into metal detectors, and then you have two of them that are going to be sitting over here onto B. Now, the reason why you want to have two on Bravo is because the back B spawns one, so you're going to be getting attacked potentially from two sides. So you need to have at least two guys to be able to deal with that. Two, you don't need two more players over here onto Alpha, because this is a slightly longer route to go into, and back C spawns are not that... what's the word I'm looking for? They're not that normal. No, not normal. They're not that frequent. There we go. They're not that frequent. If they're going to have outside spawns, they're usually over here on or over here by Bravo. There are some over here on C, and yes, they will happen, but most of the time they are over here onto Bravo, right there, where he just spawns in. And then they're on the backside of B. So if you just set one player here, if he does get in trouble, you can have the guy over here on Snake transition back over or jump into Connector and wait over here in the J, or he can just turn straight around and look this way, and if they do try to cross, he can try and pick them off as they do. And then the guy in the metal detectors can easily just whoop, jump right in here in the medical. He can shoot down to the backside of medical. He can also shoot into J here, throw a couple of nades, wait for this guy to spawn back in, and there you go. You have instant three-man hold on Alpha, and you're okay to go. So that AB hold is really, really good. Or AB hold is really good. AC is the easiest one, just because you don't have to worry really about any back spawns. There pretty much never are back C spawns there. And there are never back A spawns that I know of if you're holding A and C. And you just contain them at Bravo. And that's probably the easiest and most popular hold. Hold that we're probably going to be seeing here. Most definitely. So it'll be interesting what comes out of it. 27 tickets left to go before we are getting started. Once again, this is the ESL BF4. ESL 1 BF4 Season Number 3 Group Stages, Group B. We're going to be watching ESC versus MHSV. Both teams have won one map, and it is all going to be up to this one last one to see who's going to be able to keep their dreams alive for the offline finals. Get that money. Everybody loves that money. And ESC here is going to be on the Russian side here. We are going to be seeing a two, possibly a three-man push. Yes, three-man push going up to B, one going up through mid. That's going to be Doobie here. He does spot out one. Pretty safe push, actually, for ESC. And they're going to go straight for this B site. Ooh, nice pickup there onto Ginnu. And they're going to be able to secure this B site here fairly quickly if Banching doesn't get a couple of kills here. In fact, I think they should just transition over to A flag right now. Forget about B. Go straight for this Alpha site. They only have one player. Only one player. Oh, my God. We do have one spawn finally going to be coming in to play defense on that A site. But Banching here will be able to pick it up. He does. Takes down Benny. Nice shot. Ginnu is also going to be sitting over here onto that B site. We do have a drawer up top, and he does try and spot him out. Nice pickups there, but he gets shot from the side from Smooth. So nice plays all around, but B flag will be going into their possession. Still no push on Alpha flag. Would love to see TY with a push over here by... Oh, Nevix is trying to get the headshot there, but can't quite connect. TY, though, going to be finishing that back up with a nice two-piece. It's like, you know what, Nevix? It's okay. I'll take care of the Magnums. You just sit there and look pretty. As TY will be able to finish it up, and they have secured this AC hold. Mr. Smooth also going to be down here in a good position to harass that B site. He does end up going down, and that's going to be a five-man contain here onto B flag. TY is going to be waiting for a push coming up through J. Ginnu is also going to be transitioning back, but they got to know that there is going to be a push coming up through a connector. Oh, with a two-man spray almost. Banching here. Let's see if he can finish it off. We do have the nade spam coming out. He did a lot of damage there with that hipfire spray. Almost getting a second one there. Pulls out that... Oh, he gets the assist there. I thought for a second he did get that kill. But he's going to be trying to go for another one here. Got a little bit of a hit markers there. His teammate's also doing a great job of covering his back. Mr. Smooth is going to be following this back up, trying to go for the hipfire. Can't find him just yet, but 114 to 117. And MHSV is looking pretty darn good out of the start of this match. Banching, though, does go down. That's a three-man wipe there onto MHSV. Nevix going to try and play defense on C-Flag. Can't quite do it. And now TY here going to be transitioning out on the outside of A. And Doobie pressuring in onto this alpha flag. Potentially going to be getting a flash. Can't do it. And has C been taken yet? C is going to be getting contested right now. Banshee goes down. Benny is going to be able to pick up one as well. 135 to 106. With the BC hold now in favor of ESC. They are behind by about 30 tickets, but they still have plenty of time, plenty of tickets on the board to really work with here. Mr. Smooth going to be playing some defense. We do have TY as well up into connector. Three-man push now going to be gearing up on the C flag. So now we should be seeing a very big counterattack happening over here onto Alpha, and that's exactly what's happening. TY going huge with a two-piece. He does trade out. Smooth, though, you got to turn around, man, and he picks it up with the hipfire. This is going to be leaving one player left alive here. Banshee going to try and follow that up. We did see the res happen, though, in time, and that means he's going to be caught in a very bad situation. Unfortunately, his teammates couldn't do it after that amazing two-piece there from TY. It wasn't going to be enough, but we do have that transition from that C site. Now going to be coming over here to B. Toffee going to be finding a couple of players from behind as he will be able to take down Banshee, but has to reload in the end. So now we do see that BC hold coming in here for MHSV. Benny going to be able to trade out, but it's not going to be enough. And look, oh my, what? ESC left A completely undefended. Oh, are we going to be seeing a hold here? If they can secure these two players here, if they can take these two players out, this is going to be huge. Now, they do leave mid slightly open. We'd like to see Mr. Nevix coming in here onto B flag to play a little bit of defense. But we do see Gerar coming back in onto this alpha site. He will be able to spot out one. Nice pickup there. And that is going to definitely leave this alpha hold open. And Gerar should be able to get a cap here. And he does. Banshee will be very low on health. Once again, using that CZ so he doesn't have a med pack. And we are going to be seeing that alpha or Bravo's Charlie hold for MHSV. Would have kind of liked him to see a little put a little more emphasis on that, but that's okay. Doobie, though, able to get a couple of kills out here on Charlie Flag. Needs to get something going on here for his teammates. As yeah, that wasn't good at all. That was an instant death two-piece there, as that nade was just sitting right there on that body. And T-Way going to try and go for a push as well onto Alpha. Don't know if I'd be that aggressive with that many players. It does leave it slightly open, and they do have the B site, which means that there are potential spawns that could happen on the backside of Bravo. So might be getting a little bit too aggressive there in that situation. And we do see Toffee here doing some work. He does go down trying to get the hipfire spray. A and B, or Alpha, is going to be getting in trouble here in just a few seconds. Banshee using that straw here, trying to get a couple of splash kill damage. And Benny does end up going down. Ginyu is going to be pulling back, but gets back rage there from Hup. Nice play. Mr. Nevix going to be playing onto this alpha flag. He's kind of caught between a rock and a hard place here. But 1A take him down, and they secure this alpha site here. Still going to be up and alive. TY going to be sitting on top of medical here. He gets taken down from behind. Ginyu going to be the last player left. Gets the hipfire spray. Can't stay up long enough. And alpha flag finally does fall and go over here to ESC with Gerar going down. That means that C flag is going to be right for the taken. That's exactly what's going to happen. Mr. Nevix going to be getting them onto the burn. TY going to be transitioning back up here. Takes down Hup, no problem. 91 to 47 MHSV looking so darn strong right now in this match. But remember, this is the first round, which means that we are playing to zero tickets on both sides. So is anybody's game still? Still very, very close game. And Doobie is going to be gearing up for trying to get a couple of kills over here on the C flag. Don't think we're going to be seeing any pushes happening just yet. Huff is going to be over here into Snake, as Toffee and Benny both going to be playing defense on metal detectors. Is Banching just looking in for those cheeky little splash damage kills. Can't quite connect with any of them, as they actually are going to be in trouble here. Ginnu going to be able to take down one and two. Gets the res as well. That means that we will be seeing a push coming in from medical, which forces them inside the situation. But Toffee pushing out at the same time, picking up a kill for his troubles. But look at that score so far, 89 to 26. B flag getting contested. Banshee pulling back, gets the hit fire spray. And his teammate still looking in for that last kill, but they do have that B site. Remember, they don't have to get the picks here. They're just trying to keep the bleed. That's exactly what's happening. Huff is going to be able to pick up one. We do see Toffee with the defense on top of that alpha flag. Nice job there. Going to be able to take down Smooth. And B flag will be getting contested and taken. But look at the back B spawns here coming back in. Ginnu going to be able to possibly get the kill on Drar. He did get the spawn. He did hear him coming off. And Drar had no chance in that situation. Four-man push now onto that Bravo flag. Still Doobie is going to be out here onto that C side. Running fairly low on ammo. He has about two mags left. And he's going to be done for. So he decides to go ahead, get the push behind him. Nevix there with some nice holds. And Doobie, not aggressive enough, gets taken down from the side. And that is going to be the game here, guys. 9 tickets to 82. Oh, my God. It's like we're watching Siege of Shanghai here. But we flip-flop the teams. And we just saw MHSV waking up here. They had such a difficult time there on Siege of Shanghai. They were not able really to get anything going on. And it was a very close game on the first round of Zavod, and then they were just like, you know what? Round number two in Zavod for the rest of the match, we are just going to kick some butt, and they did. 82 tickets for MHSV going into the second round on lockers. You take a look at the KDs right there. 19-7, TY, going big. 12-12, Banching. Mr. Ginnu going to be going 9-14, going a little bit negative there, not too bad, but he did have a couple of really good plays. And then, of course, on the ESC side, we did have Toffee going 15-10, 12-13 for Drar, and 10-5 for Benny. But Doobie, 1-10. What is going on there? I don't want to pick on anybody here, guys, but 1-10, that's pretty brutal. I mean, you got to start shaping up. There's no reason to go 1-10. In this map, so yeah, definitely need to step up for this next match and this next round, because like I said before, this is do or die time. ESC's chances going into the ESL1 offline finals ride on this right now. And MHSV, if they do win this, is going to be another rematch versus MYM, as MYM did lose, and they are going to be in the losers bracket finals waiting for the next team to play. So here we go. 36 tickets left to go. We have switched sides. Is MHSV going to go for a very big mid push, or are they going to go for fairly safe where they send one out to sea, maybe two out to sea, and they only really play defensive in mid? They try and hold that AC hold. I would like to see a very aggressive push to B flag. Get those initial frags going off first, and you can't wipe. You can't wipe. If you wipe, you're going to be giving up C flag fairly quickly and potentially A as well. All right, and here we go. We are going to be breaking out, and we do see a three-man push. Going to be going straight up for that Charlie flag. One is going to be stopping over there next to Snake. And look at this. We're going to be having a very aggressive push coming out from Huff. Huff will be able to take down Banching. Has to back out, but they already got one into connector. Toffee here is going to be out for blood. They're ready for this. Toffee does end up going down. That was going to be Smooth there with the pickup. And Ginnu will be able to spot out one coming up through connector. Once again, Huff is going to be coming up through here. Gets the res. Hung up on his teammate just a little bit. And that is going to be an alpha flag going over into their favor. We have yet to see a flag here for MHSV. Nice pickups there onto Ginnu. Can he make it a two-piece? He does. Beautiful shots coming in for Jarar. And that's going to be a full wipe there onto the Alpha site. C-Flag finally going to go into the possession here of Nevix. But this is going to be a brutal hold here. If they can hold them out, there's those C-spawns like we were talking about before. Let's see if ESC is going to be able to do this. They have the great hold here. They're going to have plenty of tickets to play with. They can do this if they are going to be able to hold off this push. Unfortunately, it looks like they can't for now. Drar will be able to pick up a couple of kills. He's very low on health. We did see a three-man push gearing up onto that B site as MHSV will be able to hold on to C as well. That was going to be Mr. Nevix there. And Toffee not wanting to do anything just yet. Was trying to wait for those spawns, but unfortunately he was found out. And nobody really repushing anywhere. Let's take a look over here onto Nevix, as unfortunately his view is glitched, and there's nothing really I can do about it. But he will be able to spot out one. Gets the pickup there onto Drar. Nice hold. Can he get the pickup here on Doobie? Doesn't look like he's going to be able to make it in time. And so we should be seeing a push coming up for the Alpha flag, which did fail. Did see three players going down, and ESC recognizing that, you know what, we're getting very low on tickets. We got to go for that three cap, and that's exactly what's happening here. Toffee getting onto that B site. We'll be able to get the gray out. And C-Flag did return into the possession here of MHSV. ESC trying to bottle up him into that B site. Still not able to get over here on the C-Flag. That's a pretty brutal hold that we do see right now for MHSV. And Ginnu is going to be going up through Connector. Nice pickup there onto Toffee in a perfect position to get onto this A site. And right now, MHSV is just too much for ESC. There's nothing that ESC is going to be able to do off of this. Even Ginnu is going to be coming around for a back rage onto the C flag. Ginnu, actually, he's going to be going in for the transition on the snow. And TY, as well as Mr. Smooth, going to be waiting into mid for any kind of a push. And this right now is just brutal. It's the waiting game at the moment. MHSV know that they only have to win by tickets. They don't have to get too crazy. They're not going to go for a 3-cap. They're not going to go for these crazy A pushes. They're perfectly content on playing defense. They know that they're winning out on their frags. They know that they're winning out on their team battles. And that's what they're waiting for. We do see Smooth and Nevix, though, going to be pushing onto the Alpha. Did recognize that there was a 3-man push there. And that's going to be a triple cap incoming here for MHSV. 100 tickets left for ESC. Remember, they have to win by 83 tickets or more in order to take this match, and that is pretty much GG's coming out. B flag will be getting taken over. TY is going to be coming up through Connector, and with that kill on Toffee, if he has a good defense here onto Alpha, there's pretty much no way. Yep, GG's are being thrown out. A Syrah kill to end it up. So congratulations to MHSV. They are going to be moving on to your Losers Bracket Finals versus MYM. And go check that out. It's going to be on the ESL Twitch stream for Battlefield 4. It should be at twitch.tv/ESLBF4 or ESLTV_BF4. So definitely go check that out. And, of course, follow them on Twitter. Go check out their website. Sign up for the Go4 Cups on Sunday, guys, as they are free, and they are a lot of fun. I will be casting those. Definitely look forward to those every Sunday. 1900 CET is when they're going to be starting, and you can sign up for them anytime. Don't have to pay to get in